Welcome to Newsline in Depth. I'm Yanaka Marie. Set in feudal Japan, the TV drama Shogun wrote its way into Emmy history, winning a groundbreaking 18 awards in a single season. The show even became the first non-English language series to win Best Drama. Yet, Shogun stands as an outlier among Japanese period dramas. The country's production of such historical films has declined so significantly that the genre's very survival is now at risk. Period dramas are very costly to make due to their elaborate costumes and intricate sets. Combined with declining viewership, production has become increasingly unprofitable. Today, we spotlight an independent film that's putting a fresh spin on period dramas. Its message? These stories may unfold in the past, but the genre itself is far from obsolete.
At this theater in Tokyo, it's a packed house. A Samurai in Time tells the story of a warrior from the Edo period, which began in the 17th century. He travels through time to the present day and finds himself at a samurai drama movie set. Where he winds up playing a character who gets killed in a sword fight. The film, full of battle scenes typical of period dramas, is a comedy.
Yonaoshi Samurai. Shinpai Muyonosuke dono. Suke dachi sasu.
I keep coming back. This is my fourth time.
I'm now into period dramas because they make me laugh and cry.
The film debuted at just one theater, but gained popularity through word of mouth. About 3 months after its release, the film is playing in some 300 theaters around Japan. Yasuda Junichi is the film's director and wrote its screenplay. He says he worked on the movie for years before finally bringing it to life.
I thought that as long as the film could get big laughs in the theater and applause at its ending, it would be okay with a rather simple script.
Most of the film is set at the studio. The process of creating period dramas, including unique sword fighting performances and filming techniques, is depicted from the time traveling samurai's point of view. The film's mission is to revitalize the period genre.
When we were kids, there were period dramas on TV every day and night, so we felt a sense of connection to the Edo period. But sadly, that time now feels really far away. I hope that by bringing back the elements of period dramas that we used to enjoy, we can show people that the world of producing them still exists, and hopefully revive interest in that world.
Toei Studios Kyoto heard Yasuda's plan and helped him realize his vision. Toei has produced numerous masterpieces during its almost 100 years in business and is known as a hub for creating period dramas. It rarely shoots independent films, but Yasuda's passion convinced the studio to work with him. Yasuda prioritized two things during filming. The first was the actors' wigs. Compared to the samurai wigs used in the film's fictional drama, the one for the protagonist from the late Edo period appears more realistic. For example, by having a natural-looking uneven hairline.
It has this small top knot with little strands of hair sticking out. It was really fun to consult with the director during the production.
The second thing Yasuda focused on was the drama's climax, a stylized sword fighting scene. Yasuda cast Mine Rantaro, a veteran actor skilled at such fighting. Not only did Mine play a master sword fighting instructor in the film, he also directed its powerful battle scene. Parts of A Samurai in Time recreate classic period drama tropes, such as when actors exaggerate their movements after being slashed with a sword. Such stylized over-the-top dialogue is a staple of the period genre. Mine says he used to shoot 4 films a day. Though he appears in fewer now, he poured his heart into the production, driven by a desire to preserve the genre.
People say the period drama is dying out, but our generation has made it this far in our careers. This is the kind of film that shows what I do and how I feel when I'm acting.
The film is inspiring the people who made it and those who watch it to keep this unique genre alive.
My desire is to make entertaining period dramas with appealing scripts and thereby create a foundation for the techniques to be passed on. I'll be satisfied if this film encourages even one person to become a samurai drama buff.
Creating a period drama independently was quite a bold undertaking, especially given the high costs involved. Thanks to help from the film studio, Yasuda managed to keep the budget at around $170,000. He covered roughly 3/4 himself by liquidating his assets. Yasuda performed many tasks himself, including filming, lighting, editing, and equipment transport. By the time the film wrapped, he was practically broke, but the effort paid off. A Samurai in Time has made over $3.3 million at the box office, a remarkable feat for an independent film. And more importantly for him, it's introduced a wide audience to Japanese period dramas.